Yeah, so I'm here today to share a little bit of a parsing story. I've been testing some parsers, and then I'm going to share a little bit about using Automator with Xcode. Well, this is more like it's called the service menu, but I might try to do a live coding later. So. Parsers. At the university we had this book. I think it's like a canonical parser book still, maybe. I don't know. It was a long time ago I was at the university. And it's more about how to build parsers. It's not like using parsers, but building parsers. And usually like they try to explain everything, and then in the end they describe that here are a couple of parser tools to use, and yak and lex is like you always say yak and lex, but you mean basically bison and flex nowadays, which is the open source versions of these tools. So yak is acronym for yet another compiler. So the parser steps is like you get the stream of bytes characters. And they go through a tokenizer that will take them in chunks and then send them into a parser that will do more of the heavy lifting. But really, in this frame, it's more like, I drew this myself very quickly this today. So Lex will generate the tokenizer, and Yak will generate the parser. So Yak and Lex is like tools to generate these tools. And for the parsers, you explain them a little bit in with the rules. And it's often called this the BNF rules. And they can look a bit like this. So you have expressions and terms, and they are to reduce stuff. And yeah, and but this should be like into a kind of a syntax that we can explain a bit more easily in code. Then it could look a little bit like that. So let's do a quick test here. So this is just a super quick thing I put together. And the funny thing is, I don't know how many, is there anybody that use these kind of tools? Ever? Ah, one guy? Yeah. Two? Yeah. So, the funny thing here I really think is pretty nice is that Xcode actually support these files. I can't zoom there, but I hope you can see. Everybody can see, but this is like a dot Y, and then it will automatically pick up and see that this is a yak file. All of the building for the building the yak compiler and everything is handled automatically and gets into the build steps. The format of this file is usually a header until you have these 2%, and then so here you can set up callbacks or declarations more or less, and then here comes the rules, and then there is like trailing. Okay. See if I can. Where do we have it? Did it take? Yeah. So now, here. So after that one, there's like a trailer, and you can do stuff. In this example, I don't have a lexer. This is like a hard-coded lexer. That will just chunk these into numbers, I think. So you get like numbers, that's the token. And we can see, yeah, I have run it down here, it worked. So, minus 2, minus 3, 34, and yeah, it calculates. But then upping the ant a little bit, because the Yak Lex tool is more for like building compilers and stuff. And I long ago I saw that SQLite, that everybody's using, I guess, actually contain a parser. So the guy that made SQLite, he actually went out and made his own compiler. So if one actually looked at the architecture of SQLite, he has like a tokenizer, and then he has a this Lemon parser, which actually does the same job as Jack and Bison, but it's because in this frame he wants to run this like a long time, and it shouldn't be a problem with memory leaks and stuff that Jack and Bison had like problems with before. I think they might have fixed those. Yeah, so keep going here. So how does that look then? It's a little of a bit of a difference. Let's see, today. Yeah, so this thing Xcode isn't really supporting so good, but so I've been playing around with it a little bit, and I think it works pretty good actually. It's a little bit of the same. You can write these constructors and destructors. I'm using that because I want to do more dynamic memory, seeing that everything works without memory leaks. I also have added, here are basically the same rules, expressions, minus, but in this one I actually added like functions. You could add like functions, right now it's just a lookup, but to get this one working, one actually needs to build the Lemon parser that will generate the parser that will be used. So I think this was so long ago I was doing this, but I think this one is the actual Lemon parser. And because this is parser Lemon, and this will be the output. So here you can see the constructor, and I think I once tried it to have to, so I could use Objective-C in this, and it my recollection is it actually worked pretty good. But here it's another kind of run loop. So you need to have your own run loop, which makes it you can actually like run it continuously. So, for instance, if I run this example, so you see it just adds and stuff like that. So that's. Some of the parsers I wanted to share here with you, but then we come to Automator. So maybe you actually could use these parsers for something else. And let's see if I can show the. So it there's something called the service menu, I'll see if I can show you like sorting lines. Figlet, I can show what Figlet is, getting some data and stuff. So, nope. That was a little bit too early. Let's see. So I have a demo here. Oh, CocoaHeads Spotify. Yeah, Daniel, you know what the coding rules at Spotify is?
Obviously not.
Yeah, so let's see here. These should actually like be sorted. So I have this, so I can sort them. So, well, yeah, now they are sorted. So that's like one of the things. What was the next? Let's see. So, yeah, here I'm trying to. This is just a very simple table view in this example. So I have a URL here that will give me some JSON. So I can just get that. And boom, I have some JSON there. And the funny thing with well, this is hard to read. Funny thing with Swift, it can almost take JSON. So you see these curly brackets? It doesn't know what that is. But if I have this service that does a pretty print of JSON, and at the same time, it will convert curly brackets to square brackets. And boom, I have something readable here. And actually, I can run this thing, and we can see. So I'm working with currencies, and this is a small database. We just pull in the... Oh, that's... terrible. Let's see. So, here we have a table with the currencies and there. Yeah, there is symbol there. So if I want to have. So what's this? Oh yeah, actually. We see, okay, if I want to have a little bit of... Now we have this so big, these fonts. So maybe this is... Figlet is a way to make these kind of funny stuff. I've been using them in different places. Like here I have... but that maybe... It should be a little bit smaller. So here I mark, yeah, fetch file is there. Another thing, if say you have like terrible XML, this is like a giant file with XML. So we're gonna do it in place here, XML to JSON. Boom, okay. I have some JSON here, but I can't read it. So let's run the pretty print. Okay, then we can start to read it and use it. Don't you love JSON? It's really good. What do I have here? Pretty print. Yeah, say I want to do a calculator. So I'm going to show how to do this. One of these services. So I have Automator here, down here. So if I run Automator, where is it? Oh yeah, I have to do new. So I'm gonna do a service. And I'm pretty old school, so I almost always used to run shell scripts. And I tick in this output replace selected text up here, and I use BC a lot. Do you use that? Maybe? No? Oh, I call this calc. So now I have a a service here somewhere. So say I have let my constant equals 5 minus 2 plus 13. Yeah, so I'm terrible at doing math in my head, so I need to use this. So,
oh, it's 16.
So, yeah, so that's what I want to share this evening. Any questions? Which? These tools are all in the system. So you have Automator. You should have Automator. I can show how and let's see. So doing the curl link. Is actually I only did the xargs cur dash rl. That's like all of it. What was the other ones? Figlet. You need to install Figlet. And usually I like the SM slant font. That's my thing. This little thing in the end here makes the comment before, so it will be nice. Pretty printing JSON. It's like there is this great tool. It's called JQ. So you can see this thing will pretty print it, and these two will just convert these curly brackets to square brackets. Sorting lines, super easy. Sort. I added K2 there. Yeah, I think I was doing. Yeah, if you have, say you have this thing now. Where are they? Pinch M. Yeah, here. So. Say you want to sort these, but you want to sort them on the letter here, and not on the type. So the K there should do it. You see, it's mixed types, but this field. So that's like just an this thing there. What was the last one? That one is a little bit of a tricky because you need to have like a tricky XSLT translation there. And then I just remove crafts there. So basically that was like 10 lines, all of it. Yeah, I can post it.
Yeah, and then post the link on
Meetup
so we all can see it, right?
Yes.
Awesome.
Yeah. So.
All right. Thank you very much,
Eduard. Thank you.